Hello YouTube, this is Tiki Bama here. I do apologize about the lighting as of right now. I know it's been well over a month since I've actually did a video, or around that time frame. I can't remember, I don't really keep track of the time. I am a very, very busy individual with things to go on outside of my time making these videos. However, there's been a lot of anger going on lately, and I figured that I should just start talking about magic and what that has to do with everything else in the world. And before you sit there and roll your eyes and go, oh my gosh, this pagan crazy bitch is going to talk to us about magic where we throw fireballs and use magic wands to summon demons and stuff like that, I'm going to stop you right there. I'm not going to go into that kind of details on magic. Most of that is D&D related stuff anyways, or from video games in general. No, what I'm going to talk about in magic is the magic that words hold and the power that they hold. This is a very important thing for a lot of pagans and Wiccans to know about, is that the words that you speak, especially when you go into spell casting and rituals, hold a lot of power. If not, they hold all the power. And the ones who say the words are the ones who have the power. So why is this actually a big deal, especially with everything going on? Well, let me put it this way. Me, being a white female between the ages of 25 and 40, would sit here and tell you that words in general hold that same kind of power. And how you use those words literally depend on the effect that everybody else is going to get from that power. So just like magic, when you say a word, the power that it's holding onto is released into the world, and everyone can interpret it in their own way. So let me give you a word that I'm pretty sure a lot of people are going to be very uncomfortable in hearing and sit there and complain to me in the chats about saying and all that stuff. The word is nigger. Now, the word itself is supposed to be a derogatory term for black people who were enslaved back in the 13th, 14th, and 15th centuries. And the 16th and 17th centuries. So, you know, the enslavements of these people. It also happens to be a word that's associated with the color black or dark color by a nation in Europe. The prime example I have for that would be Schwarzenegger, where his last name is, you know, Arnold Schwarzenegger's last name happens to be black, black. So to sit there and say that people can't use the word nigger because it's a derogatory term is pretty much you claiming that you hold all the power on who can and cannot use that word. Especially when I hear right outside my door, "Nigga, shut the fuck up!" Okay? So that right there is telling me that you hold all the power for this one word, and nobody else is allowed to say this word but you as an individual. Another word that seems to hold a lot of power happens to be the word black itself. Or rather, a constant battle with this word and another set of words would be African American. I don't know if I should be calling you black. I don't know if I should be calling you African American. However, according to a very reliable source who wishes to remain anonymous, there's actually three races when it involves these kinds of people. You have black, which are the people who are not prude but are proud to still call themselves Americans. You have the African Americans, who are the black people who are prudes and want to be associated as their descendants. And then you have the niggers, which it tends to be more centered and socially connected to the people of the Black Lives Matter movement, where they don't care about their own community, they just want to see other people suffer. Okay? And this is what this individual had stated these three races to be. So when I look at a census paper, normally I see African American slash black, and then I also see the word Caucasian slash white. What I do not see is Asian slash yellow. I do not see Mexican slash brown. I see Mexican slash Hispanic, but I don't see Mexican slash brown. And I really don't see any other things like people from the Middle East going Middle Eastern slash darker brown. You know, these colors, people sit there and say that we don't need to be we need to be colorblind. And I'm perfectly accepting of that. I mean, if I see a guy walking down the street, or a girl even, the first thing I'm going to notice about them is not the color of their skin, or their hair, or anything that's physical outside of their gender, or at least what I think of their gender to be based on how they are presenting themselves. If they are presenting themselves to be a man, then I'm going to assume that they're a man. If they tell me that they're a woman instead, I'll be like, oh, my bad. I didn't see that. And in short, the words themselves have power. So, just like magic, when you use those words, and you're the only ones who can use those words, you're literally putting that power, restraining other people from using that power, either on yourself or to just communicate with each other. That's why magic is in connection with this, because with magic, there are power in those words. And the same thing can be said with magic and politics. There is power in the words that these people are speaking about. I mean, I was all for Bernie Sanders. I wish he was running, and unfortunately, he's no longer running because of people seem that Hillary Clinton's the better choice. Well, you know what? I don't think Hillary Clinton's the better choice. I'm going to be voting for Donald Trump now. There is words in my power. There is power in my words. I'm going to vote for Donald Trump. Donald Trump is going to get my vote, and that is my power being used right there. That is the magic of the power in these words. Another word that has a lot of power, and it's always associated with a negative energy and emotion and just all this feeling, and it's a word that a lot of people don't like to use very often, or if they do like to use it, they use it in a very wide range without any real meaning behind it, and that is the word hate. To truly hate something or someone, an ideal or physical thing, you would have to completely, and I mean completely, utterly despise every single thing about that. So for the people in the Black Lives Matter movement who hate police, they hate the fact that the police officers are helping people who are asking for justice to be served. They hate the fact that police are making sure people are not causing accidents. And they hate the police who are actually there for an accident to make sure that nobody else gets involved in these accidents and continue to direct traffic elsewhere. Hate is a very strong word. It is a very strong, powerful word. And there's a lot of magic. It's all negative emotions tied up and knotted into that word. So if you're going to sit there and say that you hate one thing, you're going to hate every aspect of that one thing. And it's like all the people who are now going to be commenting in this section below. I hate you. You're such an idiot, Tiki Bomber. You know? They're going to hate everything about me. They're going to hate the fact that I'm a woman. They're going to hate the fact that I have ideals that don't communicate with their ideals. They're going to hate the fact that I said the word nigger 4 times already in this video. They're going to hate the fact that I speak my mind and I don't care about race or anything like that. They're going to hate everything I represent. And I represent a lot of things, you know? They're going to hate that I'm asexual. They're going to hate that I'm a brunette. They're going to hate that I'm wearing a Batman's nightie right now. They're going to hate that I'm a pagan. They're going to hate that I'm white. They're going to hate that I have green eyes. They're going to hate that I have a mouth. And their dick isn't in it. Or their cooch isn't up against it. You know? The word hate is a strong word. And it is full of all this negative emotion. And with magic, just like magic, it's not a word people should be using very often. And it's unfortunate that I hear people use that word as often as I hear the word regret. Regret is another word that should not be used very often. People ask me, you know, people regret the stupidest things, like, I regret eating breakfast this morning. No, that's not a regret. That's just I wish I didn't eat breakfast this morning. You know? Regret means that you wish to take back on the one action that you did. So to eat breakfast, you wish to take that action back. The unfortunate side is if you don't eat breakfast, you know, your mind's not as focused, you're not as alert, you're not awake, and all this other fun crap that they love to shove down your throats on growing up. People ask me if there's things I regret, and I tell them yes, I do regret. I regret very few things, and when I do regret, it's only 3 things. I'm not going to repeat those 3 things right now because I can't actually recall what they are. Because this isn't about me regretting. This is me educating people about the magic in words and how powerful and potent they really are. A literal vocabulary breakdown. So regret is a word. Hate is a word. You know, these are words that hold a lot of power, and people don't realize it. And the more times that they use it, the less holding that these words have. Another word that happens to fall into this category happens to be the word sorry. If you're sorry, you would not keep repeating on doing the same actions over and over again. You're not sorry if you keep repeating yourself sorry over and over again. You know, saying sorry all the time literally demeans the word sorry itself. It's like saying the word rape every time for everything demeans the word rape itself. There's a lot of other words out there. I can't really think of them at the moment. However, these words are getting demeaned heavily every single day by people using them with inaccuracy and at an unbelievable rate. You would not believe how many people I hear talk about how they get raped because they just witnessed a woman walk into a puddle. That's not rape. That's disgust. You know, rape is an actual act that is being inflicted from one person onto another in a sexual content when the second person did not wish for that sexual content to happen. I know, the Webster Dictionary is forced to penetrate or forced by penetration. However, I believe that rape can be happened orally, where a woman would be forced to be eating another woman out, or being eaten out herself, where a man can be forced to penetrate a woman, or be taken by another man. You know, rape does have a broader definition. However, it's not broadened out to your feelings of disgust and distrust and disdain. It's not centered around what your emotions are. Honestly, I'm going to use a word that I'm pretty sure everybody else is going to think is a negative thing and go ahead and yell at me even further. I feel very swastika today. How about you? That's exactly what you're doing with the word rape. You're taking it, you're twisting its meaning for something else entirely different, and it's throwing the people who are real victims of it out the door, quite literally, out the door under a bus while it's on fire. The word swastika, which, by the way, thousands of people have died under the insignia of the swastika itself, would be sitting there in horror because of the fact that I use this word in a positive aspect to mean that I'm in a great mood. Okay? This is exactly what the word rape is doing to people. You're twisting it and making it demeaning. Just like hate and just like nigger. If you want the words to hold their meaning, stop pulling the magic out of them. Until next time, this is Tiki Bomber signing out. Peace.